I took this tile, this pattern from a lesson that Rick Roberts, one of the originators of Zentangle, put up on the app, the Mosaic app. And it just seemed like such a fun thing and simple enough. And I may even add a little something else to it at the end. This particular tangle in the middle is called Rixty, R-I-X-T-Y. It was created by Maria and given to him as a gift for his 60th birthday. So this is Rixty for when Rick turned 60. They love great puns and great wordplay. If you haven't ever watched them tangle, it's kind of a treat. I should put some links up on our webpage so that when you have a moment, you can slip over there and just listen to them. They're very kind and forgiving. And they really do espouse the no mistakes philosophy. I think I'd like to begin just on a little piece of scrap paper and just show you basically how the Rixty works. Well, let's see. Here we go. So this is R I X T Y. And in many ways, it's like poke root, poke leaf. But we start with Rixty with a stem, and we put a line across, and then we color in a little bit there, and then we go around this and make an aura. After we've got this down, you can play with the shape of Rixty and the way you use these different things. The general way of handling it, though, remains the same. And then you can do, if you want to make a border of Rixty, you can just come out of the top, or if you want to like make a vine of it, just come out of the top and keep on going. Or you can come out of the bottom, or you can make a circle, which is kind of how we're going to begin. And we start on our tile in a minute. It'll be something like that. Of course, you'd be a little more careful than I was there. So it's making a little couple of little V's, little wedges at the top of those two things, and then R-ing it. And you just keep going. And then later, if we have some gaps, we might fill in with some little tipple and go from there. So with that, let us take a sip of water and take a new tile. If you have a tan tile and the Renaissance stuff, fine, use it. If not, use the white tile and it will be just fine. I am certain. And so let us begin with a few moments of gratitude. And then let's go ahead and put our dots in the four corners, turning our tile. And then drawing our lines, connecting the dots. And then let us begin in the center. And we'll work out
Is this black or brown?
I'm sorry, it's brown. I'm using the brown 01. But if you want to do it in black, that looks good too. You may have more or fewer of these. It really doesn't matter. It's all going to be pretty random. Might and draw a few behind. Now you can keep turning your tile, and then I'm going to add about another row of things here and then fill in a few places. I want to leave about an inch, 3/4 of an inch or an inch around the edges of this. And then we're going to come back and aura all of this. So we're not going to fill the whole square. Okay. At this point on my tile, I think I've got enough little rixties. We can always add some more later if we want to. And I'm going to begin to fill in the interstices, that's the little spaces in between, with some little orbs. And doesn't have to be everyone, but every little space, but a lot of them. And then once we've got that kind of together, then we're going to switch to a black pen and aura this. But let's go ahead and take our time and finish this up. We've got no rush. We have plenty of time tonight. Now, you may find that some of your little rixties get out of hand and kind of break away into these open spaces. The little ones kind of work their way through. And then I think I'm going to fill in a little bit between the orbs and the rixties, but maybe not in every space. All right, I'm back. At this point, let's switch over to our Micron Black. And we're going to aura around this. We'll give it a little space. But when we aura, let's go behind the stems that got away from us. Okay. And now let's make a bigger, leave a bigger space between the auras and do another black one. Like so. Turn your tile to keep your hands comfortable.
And since we're in Aura City, pretty much, let's go around one more time, but this time a little narrow one, like that. And believe it or not, one more. This one wider, like that. Take your time. Okay. So now let's put some orbs, squish them in. And then we'll fill in around them. Okay. We're pretty much done with our pens. Now we get to play shading. So grab yourself a graphite pencil. And let's go in here all around these edges. So that the center part looks like it's sunken over the under the frame. And then on these pearls, let's put a little graphite. Next to the inside. And then we're going to come back with our tortillon. Not over the whole pearl, but about halfway. Okay. So I'm gonna come around and just lightly smudge it and then toward the center a little bit like that. Now, let's go for our white pencil, our charcoal pencil. And start in the middle. We want this center part to come forward. You have the edges going backwards. And so this will then, we'll put the highlight, and these will advance this part of the decoration will advance toward it. And if you've got one lying around, find a portillon that doesn't have black on it, or take one that does have black on it. I think I showed you one time how to run it on an emery board, so you can just take it and pull it, you know, this way, and then it pretty much cleans it off. But taking a more or less clean tortillon and then gently pushing this charcoal into the paper, easing it into the paper, as they say, just very lightly. And then maybe you want to bring the black up a little bit more. Another thing you can do, if you really want to get it dark at the edges, you may not have this with you right now, but you can get a colored pencil and right at these edges you can color it in even darker. I don't know, can you, if you can see it, the light sometimes washes the black out. You can make it darker. Or you can just use your graphite pencil, a very dark number 2 or a number 1 or anyway, a soft lead graphite pencil, and work that way too. Then I'm going to add some white here. I'm just going to, that contrast with the dark and the white, will make that center part recede even more. And then gently smudge this into the paper. And now let's go around the edges of our little pearls, just like that, as though the light is hitting them. You may have to sharpen it a little bit. I use this sharpener. I have a number of them, but this one works well. And finally, we can just take care of the background. I don't know if y'all brought your gold pens or not, but I'm gonna just be bold. Just use my gold pen around the edge. Like that. Or you could use a brown or black pen to just kind of define the edge if you want to, or even both. And then I'm going to go ahead and pretend that some of these little orbs in the middle are golden. Just a few of them. Okay. I think this is where I stick a fork in it. Call it done. But I still have to put my chop on it. So I'm going to do a Maria kind of chop. She always makes them very whimsical. Oh, I didn't quite do that right. Oh, well. So there I'm done. I may add something else tomorrow. I come in and see it, but we'll see. I think you could do something like this with quite a few different tangles. You could just all sorts of different tangles. You could put a frame around it, a little white, a little gold, and just not have to think about it too much. Just use it for a meditation.
Anyway, I want to thank you all for tangling with me this evening. And hello. But thank you all. And
thank you. Have a great night. Enjoy your week.
You too, and we'll see you next week.
All right. Everybody take care.
Bye. Thanks.
Bye-bye.